get the exemption of below 100 kilowatt projects as well in a bundling scheme. Cumulative capacity should be 100 kilowatt, and you can get the exemption. The process is also, earlier it was manual, now it is an online process. It is a completely pain-free process now. So as well in my PPT as well, you'll find it on the internet as well. So there are certain items which are eligible for this exemption thing, and certain ineligible items also. The list is also available on the MNRE website. Here I am giving you in a brief, which we can figure it out in four major components, that is solar block, power evacuation block and measuring instruments. There you will see it has covered most of the equipment which any any developer required to get your solar project done. It includes your solar modules, pin mounting boxes, inverters, cables, structures, each and everything. But it doesn't include your civil work items, your earthing or LA things, and any plant security, boundary walls, CCTV things and all. So to start with, earlier it was a manual process. You used to get all the things, all the detailed project reports, plant layouts and everything. We used to get it manually done. Then we used to go to the chartered engineer to get all the things scrutinized. And then a BOM approval team is there in MNRE. So it was a time-taking process. A lot of hard copies need to be submitted to different officers, and it was time-taking as well. Now all the things have been online, and it is a very improved process as of now. But I can brief you here. Earlier it was it takes 1 month to 2 month time to get a BOM approved. Now it is 7 to 10 days maximum. The process is completely online. You can monitor your projects. You can see it is on first come first serve basis. You can see where actually your project is standing. You have uploaded if you have uploaded your document today and someone has uploaded it on the next day, your BOM, if it is error free, will be done first, then they will move on to the another BOM. That is the completely transparency they have came up with. And development of the online system is there in my slides also. It has minimized the processing time. Earlier we used to get a single certificate, we used to get in 3-4 days. Now the next day we are getting certificate. It is very easy, as the dispatches are not delayed due to this. And they are also developing the digital signature thing. It will be enforced before GST also. In 2 months time and it will be enforced. So we need, right now what we need to do is we need to upload all the documents in their online software. And certificate we still need to get it in a physical copy, we need to get. But after this, they get along with digital signature thing. Certificates also we can download it from the user ID and password designated to the developer, and then it will be more easy. So here are some points of development of the online system basically. Here is a screenshot that how you can register with MNRE of for the BOM approval thing. This is the portal, link is there. I'll share it with you if any one of you want. We have to create a user ID and password, then we have to select it is a grid connected project, opted project or bundling project. Here after the opted is written, there is a point of bundling as well. We can select bundling. If suppose anyone needs to apply for a 20 kilowatt pipe project, then he can apply in the bundling scheme. The solar power developer, the end client need not to be same. Earlier it was there 100 kilowatt capacity, cumulative capacity they asked for, but it has to be under one client only. Now there can be n number of clients, but cumulative capacity should be minimum 100 kilowatt they are taking up. You can add up suppose 10 projects, 5 projects, and if the cumulative capacity is 100 kilowatt, you can apply it on the behalf of PTC and get the exemption done. Here are some of the screenshots of the process, how it is done, and here is the list of the documents. You have to upload there the document, LOA document, PPA document, DPR, ETC document, SLDA notes. All of you must be aware about all the design engineering things basically, and your PPA document. So So this is a like copy of the certification of the empanel chartered engineer. After you get all the things uploaded in the uploaded in your that portal, you get the certificate which you have to like get it signed for many of the chartered engineers. He will be scrutinizing all the all these documents, all the SLDs like layouts or the DPR, cable calculations and all. After that, you will be like approving this. So this is the next step, and at the end, you will be then after approving, after uploading all the VOM related documents, you will be getting a list of the VOM, which is in the form of 4 pages. In this has a detail about the solar power developer, the each and every component of how much metric ton of structure you are using, how much how much length of cables you are using, and this has to be compulsory scrutinized by the chartered engineer. And the suppose if you are applying for 100 kilowatt, it should not be more than a specific limit decided by the MNR. See, it can be, the variation can be 5 to 10%, or in certain in special cases it can be different, but you need to justify in different cases, like why you are asking for more cables, why you are asking for more structure. Suppose for if you are asking for a canal top project, your structure requirement is high compared to a rooftop project, so that is justified. But if you are asking suppose a more structure for a rooftop project, then this won't be, they won't be giving any exemptions or any benefits to them. So moving ahead with this, the results are achieved. Now the process is online and very pain free. Time is very much minimized. You get the this 10% of your project cost. Total project cost is reduced. And now with the new online and bundling scheme, excise and custom duty exemptions are more easier with MNRE. You need not to go again and again to MNRE and justify yourself. And one more thing I would like to add, the scrutinizing of VOMs is done by the MNRE approved chartered engineer. So the the design responsibility or the responsibility of the project, which only and only EPC developer has, it is shared by a ministry approved person also. Because he has only authorized all the design engineering and other things, other cable calculations and all. So this is the thing. And one more, at last I would like to add about the GST thing as well, in the predictive sheet of excise duty exemption. It is still 12.5%, which is still going to be there after this, after 1st July also. But we can't be very concrete on that. We have to wait for the till 1st July. Until each and everything we get on paper. If we have any questions, you are free to ask. And still, if anyone wants to get more details about this, if anyone wants to get more details about what are the eligible and non-eligible items of this VOM thing, you can take a screenshot of this. My number and details are given over there. You can get in touch with me anytime.